Hello viewers, before I begin with today's lecture, I would like to mention that this video is a part of the initiative taken up by the Zoological Society of Assam and has been prepared in accordance with the syllabus for the students pursuing the graduation in zoology. So today, I will be discussing about one of the most important part of economic zoology, that is lead culture. So today's learning will include a brief introduction about lead, then life cycle of lead insect, followed by lead culture practice. Related to this, we have enemies of lead, and finally economic importance of lead. So, first comes what is lead. Lead is a natural resin secreted by the lead insect Leciferleca. Here we can say what is resin. Resin is a solid or viscous substance of plant or animal origin which is readily convertible into polymer. The term lead is derived from the Sanskrit word laksha, which means a lakh or a 100,000. And here it refers to the large number of lead insects which secrete lead. Lead produced is a mixture of resin, dye and wax. On the other side, we can see the picture of lead and an adult lead insect male. Lead insect was first discovered by French missionary Father Tuchert in 1709. Hence, it was earlier named as Tuchertia leca. Later, James Kerr gave the first scientific account of lead insect in 1782, which was published in the Philosophical Transaction of Royal Society of London, and it was renamed as Leciferleca. Lead insect is a minute, crawling, scaly insect with suctorial proboscis. It lives as a parasite, or we can say that it is a natural pest which feeds on the sap of host plants. Female insect is ovoviviparous, which means that the embryos develop inside the eggs but remain in the female's body until they are ready to hatch, and it undergoes incomplete metamorphosis, whereas the male insect undergoes complete metamorphosis. And this is one of the most important characteristics of lead insect. On the other side, we can see a pictorial diagram of adult male and female lead insect. And this is the systematic classification of lead insect as given by James Kerr. Next comes the life cycle of lead insect. Life cycle of lead insect is completed within 6 months. In the picture, we can see the pictorial diagram of life cycle. As a male insect undergo complete metamorphosis, it transforms into another form. It loses its proboscis and develops antennae, legs and a single pair of wings, and hence its life cycle consists of 4 stages, that is egg, larvae, pupa and adult. On the other hand, the female, after undergoing incomplete metamorphosis, retains their mouth parts but fails to develop any wings, eyes and appendages, and its life cycle consists of 3 stages, that is egg, nymph and adult. So first comes egg. The female lays about 200 to 1000 eggs. Hatching occurs usually after 2 to 8 hours. After hatching, first instar nymphs called as crawlers emerge, which are tiny crimson red in color. This emergence of nymph from eggs is called as swarming. The nymph then sucks sap from the soft twigs and after a day or so starts secreting resinous substances from dermal glands. The secretion becomes hard and forms a hard coating over the nymph. Molting occurs thrice and the third instar larvae develop into adults. Then adult male soon after emergence move to female cells where the mating occurs for about 3 to 4 days and thereafter it dies. The females lays eggs for about 5 weeks and dies, and the females secrete lac till the end of her life. So next comes lac culture practice. Culture of lac insect for commercial purpose is known as lac culture. This involves proper care of host plants, regular pruning of host plants, propagation, collection, and processing of lac. Lac insect is polyphagous, which means that its feeding is not restricted to one particular plant, but it can survive on many host plants. So these are some of the host plants of lac insect, out of which Buteo monosperma, Sclacera trajana, and Zizipus mauritiana are considered as important host plants. Lac obtained from Sclacera trajana is considered as superior resin in comparison to others. On the other side, we can see some of the pictures of host plants. Next comes steps of lac culture. The first step is inoculation. This is of two types. First, natural or self-inoculation. This occurs by natural movement of swarming nymphs from one plant to other. And the other one is artificial inoculation. In this method, swarming nymphs are inoculated into separate host plants. This method is initiated by pruning of host plants. Later, fresh cut pieces of twigs bearing mature lac are tied on the newly developed branches of host plant. The larvae later emerge out of mature lac and settle on new branch after swarming. On the other side, we can see three different ways of artificial inoculation. In India, two strains of lac insects are cultured. One is Kusumi, which is reared on Kusum plant, and the other one is Rangini, which is reared on host plants other than Kusum. And for each strain, two crops are cultured at different times, and these crops have different inoculation period and harvesting period. This can be seen in the table. Next comes harvesting. Harvesting is a process of collection of ready lac from the host plant. So, two types of harvesting can be practiced. One is immature harvesting, where the lac is harvested before swarming and the lac obtained is called as airy lac. And the other one is mature harvesting, where the collection of lac is done after swarming and the lac obtained is called as empty lac. But out of these two harvesting, mature harvesting is generally practiced since immature harvesting may damage the lac insects. In the picture, we can see the emergence of lac insect, which means that the lac is ready to harvest. Second step of lac culture is lac secretion. So, after the nymph settles on new branches, it sucks the sap and secrete lac from the dermal glands. Insect body ultimately gets covered with lac, called as cell. These are uniform shiny coating which gradually increases in thickness, resulting into continuous encrustation formation called as stick lac. On the other side, we can see the picture of swarming of nymph and cell. So, the final step in lac culture is lac processing. This involves the following. The stick lac formed is removed from the twigs of host plant by scraping. The raw lac obtained is known as stick lac. The stick lac is then tied in bundles and immersed in water for 3 to 4 days. Later, it is dried and scraped, followed by crushing by hand mortars, resulting into an amber-colored granules called as seed lac. On the other side, we can see the picture of lac encrustation, then stick lac and seed lac. Following this, the seed lac formed is then packed in 10 to 12 feet long slender cloth bags and heated above the charcoal fire and twisted when lac start melting. The molten lac then flows out through the pores of the cloth, leaving behind the residues called as kiri. Lac is then allowed to solidify into round button shaped form called as button lac, which can be seen in the picture, or pure lac, or sometimes broken into thin small flakes called as flake lac. Next, the flake lac or the pure lac formed is then stretched into thin sheets called as sheet lac. Then sheet lac is then dissolved in suitable solvent which produces white or orange liquid called as shellac. And this shellac is the most purified form of lac. We can see this in the picture. Next we have enemies of lac. Lac culture is subjective to both biotic and abiotic factors. Abiotic factors include high intensity of high temperature, high humidity, heavy rainfall, and strong wind. Under biotic factors, we have insect enemies. This can be categorized as parasites and predators. So first, parasites. Parasites cause about 5 to 10% crop loss per year. These include chalcedoid species such as Peractrodrinus clavicornis, Erancirtis duvetzi, Eupelmus techardi, Techardiphagus techardi, and Tetrasticus purpurans. And these parasites lay eggs in the lac cells and the grubs devour lac cells inside the cells. We can see some of the picture of parasites on the other side. This is the table showing some of the important parasites of lac insect. Important parasites such as P. clavicornis, E. duvetzi, and T. techardi belongs to family Anseratidae, whereas E. techardi belongs to family Eupelmidae and T. purpurans belongs to family Eulopidae. Next comes insect enemies as predators. Predators cause about 35% damage per year. Three main predators of lac insect are found. These are Lepidopteran species, that is Eublema amabilis and Pseudohypatopa pulveri, and a Dipteran, that is Chrysopa species. The moths lay eggs on the lac encrusted branches, and the larvae spend their entire life inside feeding on the lac insect. And a Dipteran fly feed on the body contents of the lac insect. On the other side, we can see the picture of E. amabilis and P. pulveri. And these are some of the important predators of lac insect. From the table, we can see that E. amabilis belongs to family Noctidae and Chrysopa species belongs to family Chrysopidae. An important predator such as P. pulveri belongs to family Blastobasidae. Apart from insect enemies, there are also some vertebrates which are enemies of lac. These are rats, squirrels, monkeys, which cause about 50% crop loss. These animals gnaw the mature lac encrustation on the tree, damage the brood lac tied to trees for inoculation, and consume the full-grown gravid lac insects. For proper management of lac culture, different methods can be followed. First is cultural control. So this includes the following process. Twigs for inoculation should be cut just before swarming to get healthy grubs and should be free from predators and parasites. After inoculation, twigs should be immediately removed. Brood lac should be destroyed along with predators and parasites. And lastly, fumigation and water immersion of lac before removing from twigs should be done. So under this we have coop method. In this method, host plants are divided into groups consisting of certain number of trees. At a particular time, only one or two groups are inoculated. After the harvest, these trees are allowed to rest and recover while the other group is then inoculated. This allows the host plants to recover alternately. Next we have artificial control. In this method, bundles of stick lac are tied with stones and immersed in water for about a week. This kills the parasites and predators as they cannot survive in water. Lastly, we have biological control. It is an indirect method for killing the parasites and predators. In this method, two end predators such as Camponatus compressus and Solenopsis geminata are considered as the most important biological control of insect predators. We can see this in the picture, and these two species are considered to reduce the population of E. amabilis and P. pulveri by 78.6%. Sometimes hyperparasitic insects are introduced which attack the parasites of lac and kill them. For example, Eupelma stachardi is a secondary parasite of Eublema amabilis. Next comes economic importance of lac. So first is lac dye. It is traditionally used to color wool and silk. In the picture, we can see a lac dye and yarn which is naturally colored with black dye, and it is used in food and beverages industry for coloring. So next is lac wax. It is extensively used as polishers and applied on shoes, floor, varnishes, automobiles. We can see this in the picture. It is used in drug tablet finishing, in products like lipsticks, bangles, back of the mirror, and crayons. Next lac product is shellac. It is commonly used as sealing wax and as adhesive for optical instruments. In the picture, we can see an envelope which is sealed with shellac. It is used as a binder for foodstuff stamp inks, as a filling material in the hollows in gold ornaments, in the preparation of gramophone records, and it is used in the preparation of toys, buttons, pottery, and artificial leather. It is also used as coating for citrus fruits and apples, and as glazing agents for chocolates and sweets, as binder for cosmetics like mascara, nail varnish, additive conditioning shampoo, as film forming agent for hairspray, microencapsulation for perfumes. In the manufacturing of photographic material, lithographic ink, and for stiffening felt and hat material, and as insulating material in electric goods. Finally, we can sum up that although lac insect is a natural pest, it is highly considered beneficial since the product yield is useful economically in comparison to its temporary damage to host plants. Hence, lac culture should be practiced since it is self-sustaining natural material, eco-friendly, biodegradable, and a good source of livelihood for the people. These are some of the suggested readings and references which can be followed further. Hope this video will be helpful for the students. For any queries, contact at the mail ID mentioned below. This is Dr. Sabine Alamthasa signing off. Thank you.